Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Well, you guys seemed to enjoy my last video about creating chroma key transitions. I showed you how to do it via Adobe Spark. However, you also had lots of questions. The main question being, how do I do it directly within LumaFusion? Well, today we're going to look at that. I'm going to show you. So let's get started. Okay, so I've already opened up a project. It's 16 by 9 as usual, 24 frames per second, and it's a Rec 709. I've got two layers. I've got a waterfall layer up here, and this is going to be my starting point for the transition. And then below that, if I just hide its visibility, we've got a kind of archipelago slash mountainside time lapse. So we're going to blend from the waterfall to this clip here. If you want to kind of do this all in the same project, then start with the clip you want to begin the transition, and below that end with the clip you want to finish the transition. We're going to use the plain white standard titles as if you've just launched LumaFusion for the first time. So we'll drag and drop that down onto the timeline. You're going to stretch it out. Usually it comes in for a second or two, but I've got it set to 8 frames. So depending on what you've got it set to and your preferences. We're then going to highlight it, and then from there, we're going to press the pencil icon. We're then going to go into the titles, and the first thing you're going to do is get rid of the text. So tap the trash can icon, and boom, it's gone. From there, you're going to tap the little plus symbol here, and we want to create several shapes, but let's start with one shape. So tap on shape, it automatically gives you a rectangle, but what we want is an oval. There we go. The next thing we need to do is change the face color. So if we tap on face color, you're then wanting, I've got sort of two greens here, but the brighter of the two greens. Just tap away from it. And then what we do here is just start to play with the actual shape and build it up from there. So let's tuck it down this corner here. Now what I'm then going to do is duplicate this shape so there's a second version of it, and then just play with the size a little bit, the shape, and we'll tuck that down there. And then I'm going to duplicate this shape again to a third option, and I'll set that there. I'm just literally making a random shape. That's the kind of line that's going to cut through this image. How we make the transition in terms of movement and filling the screen comes down to frame and fit. So once you're in frame and fit, basically this gets treated as one element. And this is why I wanted to show you this way. The minute a second you come into frame and fit, if you've got something up at the edge, you will see it gets cut off. And we actually don't want that. So let's reset things, go back into our titles, and move everything into the middle. And again, we can just play with the shapes, stretch them out. So we're kind of doing a kind of, I don't know, question marky bubble cloud type thing. I might even add a fourth one. Yeah, I think I will. So we'll just bring that down there. There we go. Once again, I'm going to go back to my frame and fit, and this time everything's in the middle. I've come in the timeline to the 5 second point here. I'm then going to move this out the way, and we're going to do this transition from the bottom left kind of up towards the top right. I'm going to drop a keyframe, and then it just comes down to your imagination how you want to actually transition this. So the next thing I'm going to do is just move along 12 frames, and then whatever you do now gets actually keyframed in. So you're obviously wanting to increase the size of the transition. We can hover over the rotation and just rotate it. And again, just increase the size, play with the shape, and stretch it that way. I'm using the sliders now. Fill up that way, increase the size, stretch it over. And this is all going to get played as one movement. And there we go. So we then just come back to where we were before. And then as soon as it hits the 5 second keyframe, it's going to transition through to clear the screen. Like so. Simple as that. So it's those, the combination of those edges and the turn just blends it through. So it just purely comes down to what shape do you want to make? Do you want to do a star effect? Do you want to do a triangle? Do you want to just do a rectangle and start from the middle and work your way out? There's endless possibilities. So once again, just play. There's the effect. And once we've got that, we come back out to our main timeline. Because the lower video underneath is tucked away at the moment, what we can actually do is render this out to our photos. I'm going to keep it to 4K, quality 75, 70 megabyte file. That's absolutely fine. Render out the 10 seconds. There we go. And once we've done that, we don't need our transition. Although if you wanted to save that, you could do. And we don't need our waterfall. And then we go into our photos, all photos, and hopefully this clip here is our transition. There we go. That's looking pretty good. So we'll stop it about here so we can see the key. And then tap on our pencil icon, go to our little lock chroma key, tap on green screen. Then all you need to do is play with the edge blur and the spill suppression, which I think I'm going to set around about there. Yes, I am. And then we can play it through again. And there you go. It's as simple as that. Just blend the two through and there we are. That's how you create a custom chroma key transition shape directly in LumaFusion. If you've enjoyed this video today, give it a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription, of course, by all means, subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to ring the bell, and that way you'll be notified of the next video tutorial. And I'll catch you later. See ya.